numeric keypads, just for numbers, or hidden potential waiting to be unlocked? Let's explore their true value and uncover a hidden, often overlooked application for keypads that may change the way that you use your workstation. I recently switched from a full-sized keyboard with a Numpad to a 65% compact keyboard without one, and I didn't miss the Numpad at all. That's a lie. I miss it. I miss it a lot. Anytime I have to type more than three numbers in a row, I miss it. I even find myself reaching my hand over to use it only for it to land on the cold, empty desk in front of me. But the extra space is nice. So I came to the question, is it a luxury or is it a necessity? While searching for an answer, I discovered a whole new use for the Numpad, but also that evolving technologies and consumer trends are threatening its very existence. Look, in a world driven by efficiency, the numeric keypad stands unmatched for manual number entry. Voice to text just isn't there yet, and the numbers at the top of the keyboard? Please. And keypads aren't just used for data entry. Have you ever heard of a Macropad? You can turn your numeric keypad into one and use it as a media player or to quickly open applications. All you need to do is reprogram your keys and get some new keycaps to match. I think if more people knew that Numpads could be used like this, they wouldn't be so quick to just toss them to the curb. On the flip side, desk space is also highly sought after. Every function on the numeric keypad can be repeated using other keys on the keyboard. Smartphone usage is on the rise, and besides, who doesn't like a nice, clean, aesthetic desk setup? So the question really comes down to, does its efficacy make up for its bulkiness? So, although that 65% Numpadless keyboard on your Amazon wish list may be looking pretty good right now, stay tuned to see how you can put your keypad to better use and what you might be sacrificing for the sake of aesthetics and space. Macropad. You heard me right. What the heck is a Macropad? It doesn't even have a Wikipedia page yet. A Macropad is a small, programmable keyboard that is gaining popularity with developers, gamers, and run-of-the-mill nerds like me. You can program the buttons to do whatever you want. Open applications, run macros, type emojis. It essentially allows you to be even lazier on your computer than you already are, but also more efficient. With a detached pad, placing your Numpad on the left side of the keyboard is possible, allowing you to Numpad with the left hand and mouse with the right hand. Does that even make sense? Upon discovering Macropads, it made me think, could I just change my Numpad into a Macropad? I mean, I use a mechanical keyboard, so all I have to do is reprogram it and then take off the keycaps and get some keycaps with some symbols that match for whatever function I set it up for. And I'm good to go. Aside from turning your Numpad into a command center, if you're an accountant, a programmer, a data entry clerk, or work in another profession where you have to enter long strings of numbers on a daily basis, the answer is simple. Numpads are lifesavers. If you don't have one on your keyboard or your laptop, you better go out and get a Bluetooth one. I mean, look at how passionately some people feel about their Numpads. I use it exclusively. Be suspect of any accountant who doesn't. Who doesn't use it? All day, every day. Cannot function without it. And there's a reason for that. Once the keys have been committed to your muscle memory, entering numbers using the keypad is lightning fast. When I tested my Numpad typing speed versus my speed at typing the numbers at the top of the keyboard, my Numpad speed was significantly higher, even when I was cheating a little bit to type the numbers at the top. Not to mention, ergonomically speaking, your wrists will thank you. All the Numpad love aside, for many people, Numpads are used sparingly. Minimal workstation setups are becoming standard and more appreciated. Many laptops and keyboards are shipped without Numpads, and yet, people are still able to enter numerical information without much difficulty. Heck, half the time people aren't even using a physical keyboard at all, instead inputting information using a touchscreen keyboard or by voice recognition. Minimalists would say that the Numpad is a bulky waste of space that creates excess with its repeated functionality. Generally speaking, you can reduce a keyboard size by 15 to 20% just by taking away the Numpad alone. On a small desk, that can make a big difference. Full-sized keyboards are also less portable than their compact counterparts, so it's best to choose a compact keyboard for traveling. If you use the Numpad sparingly, some users have hypothesized that it may even contribute to poor ergonomics. You see, righties using a full-sized keyboard must keep their mouse further away from the QWERTY home row and angled off to the side, which can lead to an asymmetric posture. It seems ergonomics can be a problem either way, depending on which tasks you're performing most often. If you forego the numeric keypad, you're forced to use the number keys at the top of the keyboard. It's not that difficult, and you may even improve your typing by creating muscle memory for those keys. Entering numbers as quickly as when using the Numpad, however, as we saw earlier in my speed test, probably isn't going to happen. The Numpad was intentionally designed to make all of its keys easily accessible using just one hand. Store cashiers hold products in one hand and enter information using the Numpad with the other hand all the time. It's these situations where the Numpad really shines. Not when it's being used by your average Jane to write an email, but when it's being used by Jane the accountant, who deals with numerical entry on a daily basis. It's these situations where you want the most efficient method of input. Ergonomics also comes into play in these situations, albeit in a different manner. When typing numbers on a daily basis, repetitively reaching for the number keys at the top of the keyboard can add more stress to your fingers than by simply using the Numpad. Typing top row letters from the QWERTY home row can also contribute to losing your place on the keyboard as opposed to easily moving from the Numpad home row back to the QWERTY home row. So at the end of the day, the question is less about whether or not a numeric keypad is necessary or not, but rather, is it necessary for you? If most of your time is spent composing documents and emails and you rarely even look over to use the numeric keypad, then you can probably do without it, enjoy the extra space, and never look back. If you're a general computer power user and you do find yourself reaching over to use the Numpad from time to time, you may be the perfect candidate to turn that dusty Numpad into a built-in Macropad program to do your bidding. If you find yourself buried in spreadsheets or programming mathematical expressions, it's probably best to consider the Numpad a necessity and to steer clear of compact keyboards in general. Personally, I think I'm going to go without it for a little while and brush up on my skills at typing the numbers at the top of the keypad. I'm not going to get rid of it though. I'm going to Macropad it. Subscribe for future updates to see how it goes. If you're looking to enhance your own typing efficiency, make sure that you steer clear of the top 10 mistakes that I discuss in this video right here. Also, let me know if you're rocking a Numpad or if you've kicked the habit. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. I'm Anson Alexander, and I will see you in the next one.